I am actually really pumped about this video. I am so excited. And I even wore my favorite cologne just for you. Perfume de Marly. How do I smell?
So good.
But this video is urgent. Actually, I want kids to see it. Now that I just said that, never mind. Kids out of the room. But millions of Americans, this is affecting all of you. And it's happening to everyone. And everyone's getting wiped out, but no one really knows what, why, or when. So in this video, I'm going to offer you problems, but then I'm going to offer you solutions. Problem number one, you guys are living in survival mode. And what happens when you're in survival mode? Well, it's just not really pretty. And some of you guys might ask, well, how bad, Johnny Bravo, is this? What are you talking about? Well, I'm talking about over half of you. 2020 has been a financial disaster. Disaster number one, and I know this because I'm married. You guys all have to walk around with your wallets and this thing that I used to use in woodshop. It's a vice. Ah, oh, thank you, brain. My one brain cell's like, you can do it, Bravo. You got this, man. But everyone and their mother, and I'll get to it in just a second. You guys are all waiting for these stimulus payments. Or the end of everything that was going to be, well, we might be ending all of these things. Well, as of today, everything has been ended, along with 70 million new claims for unemployment. And it continues to move. Move what, Bravo? Yeah, how about almost $30 trillion in debt? Remember when we're like, oh, we're at $2 trillion in debt. Now our deficit, our yearly deficit, what are we, like $4 trillion? And just in case someone decides to troll and say, well, it's not $4 trillion, Bravo, it's actually $3.2 trillion, 3.3, probably by the end of the year, maybe get it up to 3.3, maybe 4, depends on how much we kick the can. And who's going to pay for that, my friend? You are. You're going to pay for that in your taxes. How much? $220,000. So here you go. Here's your $600,000, but you just have to pay back $220,000. So the new survey says that over half, 55%, consider 2020 a financial disaster. And what are you going to have to do? 62% of you are going to have to take out another job. Why is that? Well, it's the system. And the system is designed to wipe you out. Wipe out the middle class. That's just, welcome to the Keynesian way. Now, kids, listen up. You have two things. You have goods and you have services. Now, don't go out there and go like, teaching high school. I'm like, so what do you want to do? Oh, I'm going to go to college. Okay, great. So what do you want to do? I want to go to college. Okay, you've been doing school your whole life. You're 28. Great. What are you going to do? Is it a good or is it a service? Which one are you going to produce in this said economy?
Well, I'm going to go get a degree.
Okay, great. That's not a good. That is not a service. You're not helping out the economy. Well, I mean, sure, the liberal college professors like me. Yeah, okay, you're stuffing my wallet because I'm providing a service. But besides that, what do you want? How do you want to add to this economy? That's how everything is. This stuff right here. This is nothing. Don't chase this because this is just sheets of paper that don't mean anything. You have goods or services. Which one are you going to pick? You're going to be on the service? You're going to be a plumber? You're going to be an electrician? You're going to do something? Or are you going to fix something? And just FYI, the service sector, the service industry is getting wiped out with stuff like this. Don't ask me what that is, but it's my elevator button. It's being wiped out 100%. So if you're deciding to get a job in the service sector, I'd say be careful. I think you'd more so want to produce a good than a service. That's just me because technology is eating everything. Yeah, fast food, barista. I know you're like, I want to go to college, get a degree, become a barista and work at Starbucks, which I think 85% of all baristas have at least a master's degree. And do you see that being wiped out with technology? I do. And what does the government do to try to fix it? They produce more of this. They're like, okay, take some more. Okay, still? No, your job's gone? I don't know. How do we fix this job thing? And then asset-related stuff continues to go up. Google, Apple, Netflix, anything that's technology, Bitcoin. Hey, That was a no-brainer. But Bitcoin is a speculative asset, so be very careful, because we are going to have more financial disasters. And the last one, eight months ago, right, took my Bitcoin. I own Bitcoin. I have for many of years. Took me down to 3,800. I said, what are you doing, Bitcoin? But at least the kids are like, hey, this Bitcoin actually makes sense. I think I'd rather do that than stocks. I know, because they teach stocks, gold, Bitcoin. I've been doing this for, 20 years. When Bitcoin came on the scene, I was like, hey, you guys like this? I like this. Like stocks? Eh. You guys want to own some gold? Nah, that's a relic. Just saying, friends, be careful. You gotta see what's coming up. And what's coming up is your kids are coming back. That's what's coming up. Coming down the street with their bags saying, I'm moving back home. 52% of young adults. Now you're like, what is that? Are living with their parents. That's the highest since the Great Depression. Now, from 18 to 30, okay, more than half of adults 30 years old are living with mom and dad. And I'll tell you, with my six, my wife would not be opening the door like that. We would be holding it. I would have 2 feet on the door like that in junior high. You know, when I taught junior high too, that's what the kids would do. They'd like hold the door so their friends couldn't come in. That would be me. Oh, that is disgusting. Look at this. Let me cast her myself so you can see it. So you're like, I don't believe that. Can you guys believe that? 52% of 18 to 29. Sorry, I rounded it. 30. It's just a dude thing, right? We always go bigger. You guys are living with your parents all the way back to the Great Depression, right back here, right? Right? Roaring 20s, 30s. Now, if we take a look at 1970, what happened in 71? That's where we started screwing with our money, right? That everything broke. When you took us off of the gold standard and allowed the government just to print like a drunken sailor, well, the kids are moving back because of it. Do you see it getting better or worse? Oh, I know, it's getting worse. It will get worse until we have a reset, and then it'll get really good, and then it's gonna go really, really bad. Where you own nothing and you're happy and you rent from the 1%, because that sounds like a great idea. And kids are like, that's fine. Do I get my iPhone? Okay. So kids out there, listen, are you producing a good or are you producing a service? Don't worry about this stuff. If you're on an island all alone and there's stacks of this and it's you and your friend, one of you guys can fish, one of you guys can build a house. It doesn't matter. If there's 20 trillion of these, it doesn't matter. Goods and services, that's what economy is. Everything else is just bubbles that governments create to try to control you. Oh, if you vote for me, kid, I'll give you $2,000. Oh, UBI, yeah, you're taken care of. It's okay. They're like, oh, you don't have any good or service here. Just take this. But this does not work. This actually takes away from your life rather than add to it. Because even though the UBI that they just gave you $2,000 or your unemployment or whatever, for some weird reason, the prices at McDonald's just keep going up. You're like, why is that? And asset prices keep going up and you try to chase that and you're gonna get very mad. And at the end of the day, you're gonna get so mad that you just witnessed it a little bit. You guys just witnessed a taste of what is about to come when you have 55% living at home. You got 55% saying that this is a financial disaster. And they're like, please, government. And then they're gonna riot. And then they're gonna go, I'm gonna take back some land. I want some of that. I don't think it's fair that you get all of it. Why is it you boomers get everything and I'm out in the street? This isn't right. You rode the asset wave and then I teach you, it's crazy that I actually, my goods and services are actually about flipping assets. I never actually thought of it that way, but when I trade a stock, when I swing trade, it's like online arbitrage. I taught that. I buy it low, I sell it high. I just flip assets. Economies shouldn't be that way. It should be, can you fish? Can you build a house? Not flipping assets because those assets are going in this direction. Come to think of it, I've been flipping assets my whole life. And then I just take it into the stock market, right? Well, this is Bitcoin, kind of stock market. You buy it there, right? You sell it there. There. You buy it here, you sell it there. You're like, why don't you just buy it hold? Because you could make so much. Well, this is not financial advice. Don't listen to anything that I say. because you'll lose all of your money. You'll lose all of your Bitcoin. You buy it here, you sell it here, and then you wait for another entry because I don't know how far it's going to go. Are we going to bounce off the 200? Are we not? I know that is not the 200 on the 1 hour, but let's just pretend. And I sit there and I go, okay, I just flipped that at 20%. I just flipped the guy off next to me because he just cut me off. Just flip that one at 9%, 10%. You know, it's like 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. And can we just have a moment of silence for a moment? Is that the craziest thing that in 1 hour, Bitcoin lost 6%? Oh my gosh, that is crazy. But you're like, but it's okay because it went up, you know, 300%. That is the one thing that Bitcoin does. It crashes up very well, right? It doesn't crash. It just crashes. It crashes everywhere. I just want to shake the kid's hand, the Robin Hood kid, that bought it at 28,403, because he knows it's going to 30, right? It's going to go to 30, even though on the MACD, it's telling you, Skyler, get out, please, son, wait till these come down, and then you can rebuy. But I guess if you don't know this, because you're not in my course, and this is the last weekend that I am offering both of my courses where you are doing this, right? You're flipping assets. That's so crazy. Or on Amazon, you're producing goods. I teach you how to produce goods like this. This guy makes how much on this good, right? You want to sell goods? I want to sell goods. That's not a service. That is a good. And this guy selling this good makes $181,000 a month. Okay, that's cool. That's a good. I need that good because when I'm out there, right, providing my service of fixing things around the house, that actually works. Or when my wife gets drunk and she needs to cap her wine bottles, with that, for the love, how much is this guy, this little plastic stuff? But I mean, come on, you guys, $300, you get two courses on goods and services, and you get to make 12, what is this, over, it's around $20,000, selling little plastic top cactus toppers for drink charms. And this is my holiday special. It is over this weekend, so don't come a-crying on Monday tomorrow, and you're like, oh, where'd it go? No, now you have to pay $2,000 for my goods and services. Or you could just send your kids my way and I'll teach them about goods and services in the classroom on how to buy. Look, this is where you buy Bitcoin. This is where you sell Bitcoin. And everyone gets so pumped and all the videos on YouTube are like, buy. This is where you sell. Can I draw it? Can I make this a little bit bigger so you can see it? See that cross? That's where you sell. Maybe, you know, you're not selling at the tippy top. What were you selling Bitcoin at? 27,000? I know the indicators went off there, but come on. That was a clear sell indicator. And this over here, that's a buy indicator, right? Even though this may have missed it. Did it miss it? Eh, it was a little early. Whatever. But you get it. And did you guys see what happened to Alibaba? Oh my gosh. But look. This is where you sell. That's where you buy. I'm not going off of my buy and sell indicators up here. This is where you buy. This is where you sell. This is where you definitely sell. I mean, it was screaming at you after hours. But hey, kids, we might. Oh my gosh, that thing is so oversold down here on the RSI. Look at that. Watch for that reversal. These two lines come together right now. But I say do something in 2021 where you're okay. Remember, two things. You have a good or a service. You produce one of them, and which one's going to be wiped out with technology? If so, stop doing that. Become a plumber. That's going to be a tough one. Electrician. There's so many services. If you like the service thing, if you want to produce goods, take my Amazon course. Learn how to produce a good. So you don't have to be this. 68% of Americans, financial setback in 2020. Do you not see that this just might happen in 2021, right? Maybe there's a new something that comes around. And governments at the end of the day, and I'm passionate about this, okay? People are like, wait, but there's the taxes are going to be so high. You want to know? Does the government care? They don't care. You want to know what a government wants? Well, they want to save themselves first. Do they want money? They don't want money. Huh, that's weird. Well, I mean, in their personal life, sure. But a government, people that run for office, all the people that are controlling you, it's not about the money. What's a sweeter taste in their mouth than money? It's control. If they can control you, they won. If they can tell you what to do and you have to do it, oh my gosh, that's the greatest thing since sliced bread, which is a good. But if you serve it at Chipotle, that is a service. And that's, but you do need a master's degree. But that's chips and salsa. They don't really give you bread, do they? Yeah. Terrible analogy, Johnny Bravo. But yeah, I actually wrestled that. I'm like, how is it that the government's allowing this? They're going to have to, they're shooting themselves in the foot. But it's okay, because at the end of the day, they get control and the people cry out to said government. And I need you. I can't live without you. That's amazing. Asset prices go up. Taxes go up. They don't care. They get to control you. But what can you do so that they don't control you? Well, you can move, right? Hi, that's me. I'm going to move to where my money is welcomed with my goods and services. That's one thing I can do. Maybe a second passport. Maybe I can get a place that has, you know, water and food. And I don't need, I'm off the grid. I mean, without getting, you know, tinfoil hat, but okay, I'm happy. The only thing that I'm not happy about in the United States of America is I can't own land. I forever have to pay tax, right? And that's how they're going to get me in the end. So I can come to the state of Texas and get away with not having to pay state tax. Okay, that's good. That's great. Until, you know, too many people from California come over and they're like, hey, I think 15% state tax is a great idea. No, they're going to get you in property tax one way or the other. And the people are going to go, yeah, that's not fair. All those rich people have land. They have a home. So let's crank the tax on them. They get to spend that money. And then at the end of the day, they get their place back. They get their land. Now they get what you just had. But that's down the road. And hopefully you'll be positioned in such a way of producing this good. What do you guys think? Good or service? You can go for goods rather than services, but you got to produce it. You got to make it for this economy. Then you don't have to be like this. And this was just want to bring 4 million Americans. Nope, 14 million Americans are about to lose unemployment. Isn't that crazy that we're all just like, we all just need benefits. We're all surviving. The world is surviving on stimulus. Where does that stimulus come from? It's going to come from you. It's either taxes or inflation. Which one? Raise your taxes or you'll see it in all the other costs. But we just went from could to is. Unemployment benefits run out for millions as Trump refuses to sign the relief bill. But that's all we are living on is just stimulus. Now, it could be, okay, here's 600, here's 2,000. But the majority of the money isn't going there. It's not going to you. It's going to the corporations. That, for example, American Airlines, which should just fail. Oh, I'm sorry. You're not flying, which that's actually the government's fault. I mean, it's like this whole circle. You're like, well, if they wouldn't have shut everything down, then they would be fine. But then it's the government, and the government wants control, and then the middle class gets wiped out. And I don't want to see that happen to you. But these money, the said digits, are going into these companies to keep them afloat. And that's what's happening. And then you have to pay it back in your taxes. And then you have to get two jobs at American Airlines. Right? It sounds perfectly fair. So just remember that. It needs to come from somewhere. It is like magical pixie dust where the Fed can create a reserve and then buy bonds. I mean, it's right. The fraud hole goes down pretty deep. But just know at the end of the day, it's inflation in something and it's taxes in something else. You have to pay for it. You see that nice shiny fire truck and their nice big, like out here in California, you guys have some rad places, I have to say. I'm like, dang, I want to be a fireman. Your buildings are like Taj Mahal. Who has to pay for that? Oh, I will. You take it out of my property tax. That's fine. Just tax me to death. And I want to give you one more analogy, just so you can kind of see the big picture and how this all works out. So the big plunge in railroad jobs. Okay, so that's your service you provide. You have a railroad job. And let me Casper myself so you can see what just happened to your railroad job, right? It's gone. It's gone. Gone, 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 gone. All of your jobs are gone. But the stock market revolving your said job is going up. You lose your job. The rich make a whole lot more money off of you losing your job by trading assets. Look at this. All of these skyrocketing. Sorry, my wife just came in and she attacked me and that would be a good, right? Oh, it's Pegasus, by the way. No, they're not sponsoring this. But guys, produce a good, produce a service. That's what I do. I figured out a long time ago. Yeah, I could be like, I'm a high school business teacher, college professor. Is that going to last? No, it's not going to last. And sorry if I ranted and raved, just passionate. I know it was my Facebook group, something. They're like, he gets really passionate. I'm like, yeah, that kind of happens. So hopefully you guys understand. I talked economy, how to figure out goods and services, trade equities, start businesses. At the end of the day, I want to see you guys survive and prosper and maybe subscribe. I did 100,000. What are we going to shoot for now, kids? We going for 1 million? I am happy. I am totally content with 100,000. That is very exciting. I want to say thank you so much, and I'll see you tomorrow.